sitekele. Limbrondo suzakanda lebrodi kesida. Thank you, Lord, for this day. We worship you for another Sunday service. Hallowed be your name, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Blessed be God for my online viewer. We worship you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen. I just want to welcome everyone who is connected right now, who's going to watch us later, that you're going to stay close to this message until finish. There's going to be a word that we hear that will encourage you in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, tonight, this day, even I'll be looking on a topic tied to the secret place. Now, when I mean the secret place, I mean the secret place of the Lord. It's not the secret that you go and hide somewhere with. No, it is the secret place of the Lord. Hallelujah. In this end time, those who survive it are the men and women who run and spend time in the secret place. When you spend time in the secret place, you come out with boldness to confront your day. As a matter of fact, you command your day in the secret place. Nothing takes you unaware when you settle it in the secret place. The secret place. As I go on, let me take our text from the book of Psalm 91, verse 1. You see, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom will I trust. In the secret place of the Lord, when you have an encounter with God, it is only God you can trust in this end time. Man will fail, system will fail, nation will fail, politics will fail, science will even fail. But in the secret place, you can trust the Lord because he's there to guide you. He's there to mantle you. He's there to carry you up. You need to enter the secret place. Say, Lord, take me to the secret place, Lord. Take me to the secret place. I want to abide in the secret place. Now look at what he said in the assurance in verse 3. He said, surely he shall deliver me from the noise of the fowler, from the snare of the fowler, and from the north pestilence. He shall cover thee with the feathers, and under his wings shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and thy buckler. True shall be, talking about the word of God, the rhema in this world. It shall be your buckler. It shall be your buckler. Kakabahiada. In verse 5, say, thou shalt not be afraid of the terrors by night, nor by the arrow that fly by noonday, nor the pestilence that wasted in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasted in noonday. A lot of things happen in the world today. A lot of things are happening. That if you are not careful, your faith will shake you. You will shake, you will move. But these are the assurance we have in the word of God. In verse 7, it says, 1,000 shall fall at the side and 10,000 at the right hand. But it shall not come nigh thee. Only with the eye shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. That demand an amen there. Only with your eye shall you see and behold the reward of the wicked. Every wicked man today and woman today, they have their reward waiting for them. But you're going to spend time in this secret place. Let me tell you that the secret place is a place of strength whereby we generate strength in the secret place. God speak to all that we should enter the secret place. You know, if you check through the Bible, men and women who conquer their time, who conquer their war, are people who spend time in the secret place. Look at Samuel. Spend time in the secret place. Look at Elijah. Spend time in the secret place. Look at Moses. He spent time in the secret place. Look at Joshua. He spent time in the secret place. No matter the prophecy that have gone ahead of you, if you didn't spend time in the secret place, you may miss it. If you don't believe me, when you get to heaven, ask Samson. Samson was born as Nazareth, born. It's a child out of prophecy to deliver the children of Israel. Somehow, he was born. In Nazareth, he met Israel in bondage. He left in bondage. Why? He couldn't spend time in the secret place. Rather, he spent time in the brothel. Hear me, if God have called you, spend more time in the secret place. Hallelujah. Spend more time in the secret place. Proverbs chapter 18, verse 1. It's a true desire a man's having separated himself. You need to come to the point you separate yourself from the world. Come to the point you separate yourself from this busy schedule you have. Separate yourself and seek an intermediate with all wisdom. Separate yourself. Every great person you see today, whether they're in the ministry or the secular world, they have spent time in secret place. The secret place is God's showroom, is incubator. The secret place is a place where it's a factory that you stay. When you come out, they will see your product. Spend time in the secret place. The secret place is also a place of encounter, that you will have an encounter with God. Moses had an encounter with God at the secret place. What you are seeing today in the life of any man who is great is a result of the encounter in the secret place. The secret place of God define who you be tomorrow. Show me a man who succeeded right now. I will tell you a special time in the secret place. You need to run to the secret place of God. What are the attributes of the secret place? Number one, it is a place of loneliness. When you are in the secret place, there's loneliness. Everybody abandon you. Everybody forget about you. People will know, we must understand you and say, what is he going through? It's a place of loneliness. You will be asking questions. Nobody is ready to give you an answer. Except God, Yahweh. It's a place of loneliness. It's number two, it could also be a place of mockery. When you're in your secret place, people begin to laugh at you. You say, what is happening to him? We thought he's up there, but how did he go down? You're in the secret place. I promise, if you stay long in the secret place, when you come out, men will seek your face, because you're going to come out as God, a representative. The secret place. The secret place, one of the attributes, again, number three attributes, is a place of labor. That you enter the secret place, you begin to labor. See, no boy, no woman go to the market and deliver a baby. Delivery is meant for the labor room, delivery room. A close place whereby they can stay with the midwife, and the midwife will tell them, push. You need woman, you need a man who can guide, who can be speaking to you in your secret place. So that you don't discourage, don't run back and say, I can't continue anymore. The secret place. When you see athlete today, whatever field it may be, you see, their strength is in the secret place whereby their coach is keeping it in there. They want to give us, they don't continue. If you have a trainer in the gym who's training you, even though you want to give up, he keep encouraging you, keep going. The secret place. It's a place of labor. There's a dimension of God that you will encounter, you that God will reveal to you in the secret place, not in the public. There's a dimension of God that He Himself revealed to you in that secret place. You ask people a question right now, run to the secret place. You don't understand what you're going through right now, run to the secret place. People have misunderstood you and call you a man of name, run to the secret place. Can't stay in the secret place until my turn comes. That was Job said. He said, all the days of the appointed time will I wait until my chinko. He's talking about waiting. I can't see Nama. There's a man that you are not watching me right now, but you're gonna watch me. They told you you have a heart problem. And you are feeling the pain right now. I prophesy to that body right now. Can they lose the dosha? Lord, give this person a brand new heart. Kidneys, every system in your system, receive a brand new one. The secret place. Joseph, hide me secret until the day you appointed for me. The mystery of God upon human beings are made in the secret place. When God wants to reward his children, he drives them to the secret place to have a word with them. See, anyone can fake power. But you cannot fake the glory of God. Let me come again. Anyone can fake the power, but you cannot fake the glory or the presence of God. You can push people to fall under the anointing. That is, you are faking it. But you cannot fake his presence, that you walk in the midst of people without touching them and they begin to fall under the anointing. You cannot fake this, that when you walk to where a sick man is, on a wheelchair, and he jump up, you can't fake it. All the things we generated in the secret place. I don't know who's watching me right now, but I'm telling you, if you feel long in the secret place, this question you keep asking yourself, whatever challenge you're going through right now, I'm telling you that God himself will answer you in the mighty name of Jesus. Run to the secret place. Songwriter say, take me to the secret place where only you and I could have communion, could have discussion, dialogue. Take me, Lord, to the secret place, Lord. Kashidadadakapada. Ekambarada. The secret place is a place of intimacy with God. It's a place of intimacy with God. That you enter that secret place, you can know, you can hear God's voice, you can recognize God's voice. And God can know that, yes, my son, my daughter is seeking my face. It's a place of intimacy. Take me, Lord, to the secret place. What are the signs that you've come out from a secret place? What are the signs? It's brokenness. There is no way you can come out from the secret place of God and you become arrogant. Brokenness. It's not enough to be available, but for God to use you. Hear this. It is harder to maintain success than to walk your way to the top. It is harder to maintain way on top than to walk your way to the top. Anyone can climb to the tall tree and stand there, but standing on the apex of that tree without shaking, it takes courage, it takes tenacity. The road to greatness is very slippery. So one of the signs that is brokenness. Now you enter another two, number two, the sign that it is his mercy that carries you to the secret place. His mercy carried you to the secret place. The steadfastness of the Lord never ceases. His mercy never come to an end. They are new every morning. Always new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, oh Lord. Great is thy faithfulness. It is the mercy of God. We keep saying in our ministry that the mercy of God is the medicine of God. You don't run to the secret place without his mercy. When his mercy tabernacle you, when the mercy is available, then you begin to act still with ease. The mercy of God is stronger than faith. The mercy of God. That you could see people, some of them have faith, but some who don't have faith, but the mercy of God comes and heal them. People today who are having big ministry today, some of them are not so much, they are not prayer world like other people, but the mercy of God is speaking for them. Number three, the Spirit of God that leads you to the secret place. Daniel went to the secret place of God for prayers, and he had an encounter with God, and that he could interpret the handwriting of the wall. He was not there when God was right on the wall, but he came and interpreted many take for if over say it's interpreting. Why? He got that interpretation for the secret place. I was telling a pastor who is inviting me for a program. I said, give me the thing, because most of the time, some of the things that God shows me in the church when I'm ministering, I got to see them in the secret place first. So when I come to the church, it's like a reminder. It comes like a flash, and he reminds me the secret place. Daniel spent more quality time in the secret place. No wonder he could confront the king. I challenge you today, no matter what you are going through now, enter the secret place. Kashila kata, begin to pray. Mando lolo bodo. It's a place of power. It's a place of power. Bonto lipra nazile kruda banasi kalahaya. Jile kozu zakabara nakande legro hosute. Jiko lombro dosike lebro dageti kalabra. Take me to the secret place, Lord, where only you and I could have communion. Mondo Suleganza la Cabantali, Iko Sulengaba la Creek, I desire your presence, Lord. Ikabarana Poro de Kilengro de Mana Silakanta, Ikronto Lombroko Sudakonka Lagaderi Kantaya, Rabra to Longreda, Anderos Kadae Kadendoho. Take me to the secret place, Lord. Take me, Lord. Mishunodo Bohoshata. Kazizegida Gada, be gonna pray. The Father, reveal yourself to me in the secret place. Go ahead and begin to pray. The Lord, reveal yourself to me in the secret place. Reveal yourself to me in the secret place. Reveal yourself to me in the secret place. Reveal yourself to me in the secret place, Lord. Shigaralamongo Hashada. Reveal yourself to me, Lord. Show yourself strong, Lord. Prove yourself, O God. Yahweh, I need to see you. The secret place. In the name of Jesus. No matter what you are going through right now, when you enter that secret place, God will speak to you like he did to Zechariah. Say, Father, speak to me. That servant heareth. Go ahead and begin to pray. Speak to me, Lord. Speak to me, Lord. Speak to me, Lord. Speak to me, Lord. Asirondo vigle dike silahaba. Bontolobrona kansile gedem sindahaya. Speak to me, Lord. Speak to me, Lord. Nengerada kansile gedem kiyato birata. In the name of Jesus. And those of you who are going through one challenge or the others, I want to pray for you. Stretch your hand to the screen you are watching me from. This hand does not separate God of love. One of the years, we in our church, a Zimbabwe lady that will pray that God healed her of HIV and cancer. They informed her that a brother in Harare General Hospital was diagnosed of kidney failure and going through dialysis. And he ran to me in the church after the service, said, God has healed me of cancer and HIV. I believe if you pray, he can heal my brother. And I said, put your brother to call your brother. I called the brother. Church after we close, I called. He can hear the voice of the brother very faint in the hospital. And I asked him a question, do you want to die, you want to live? He said, I want to live. I said, Lord, you see, most time God works when we pray even shorter, he works. It's not the longevity of the prayers. I said, God, give him a brand new kidney. That was on Sunday. On Monday, the brother is scheduled for another dialysis. As he entered the machine, they found out they had a new brand new kidney. They refunded his money he deposited. So this hand does not separate God from love. Wherever you are, stretch your hand to the screen and watch me right now. Father, I ask, by your mercy, move right now through these airwaves. Whether they are watching me right now or they're going to watch me another day, Lord, every sickness in their body, every challenge they're going through, by the power of the Holy Ghost, let them be healing now in the name of Jesus. Means Tunka Talibe Rina Mahasa. The someone you keep having times blood runs through your nose. When you do some hard labor, you see blood dropping from your nose. I rebuke that blood now, never to come again in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Whatever pain in your body, receive healing right now. Receive healing right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I agree with you that you can't be sick anymore. That sickness, whether cancer, diabetes, leukemia, stroke, paralysis, whatever the sickness may be, I don't get to know. It has a name. In the name of Jesus, I challenge you. Bow. Let the people go free. I declare you healed right now. You are healed. I say you are healed. In the name of Jesus. Congratulations. Please write to us. You see our website is screen on the screen. Go to that website, write to us. Let us share your testimony. Let us get a testimony. We need to hear your testimony. Share your testimony with us and we'll share with other people, because it encourages people. It builds up their faith. Hallelujah. Now, if you don't know Jesus, it's a time. I've done that many years ago. Say, dear Lord Jesus, I am a sinner that need repentance. Have mercy on me, Lord. I believe you died and rose up for me on the third day. I declare with my mouth and I believe in my heart that I'm safe. Thank you for saving me. In Jesus' name. The Lord will affirm your prayers and your confession in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, before we end this telecast, please, if you want to give your offering, go to our website and drop your offering there. All right, you don't need to come to South Africa to give your offering. Wherever you are in the country, the good news is that you can give from with any currency, with any card. Just go to that website and follow that form and fill it up. Drop any amount you want to give, some offering or a seed to this ministry, As we receive it, we're going to write to you and appreciate it in the name of Jesus Christ. You are blessed for it. Let me pray for your offering. Father, I pray for this offering right now. Lord, bless the givers in the name of Jesus. Increase will go on the harvest in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you for sowing the seed of this ministry. Your life will never remain the same again in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We cherish your relationship. And I trust the Lord that God will speak to you so that you could partner with us, a monthly partner, to do more things in this ministry. We're going to take over the airwave. Now, before we sign up now, please go to Amazon or our website or Google Play Store. You could get our books from there. Just order them. It could be delivered to you by hard copy, or you download the soft copy and read. All right, it's going to bless you in the name of Jesus. Please don't forget that we're also going to reach out to you on Thursday. And the Lord will bless you. The Lord will keep you in the mighty name of Jesus. Remember, no matter what is happening right now, know that the same God is still at work in your life. Cha cha, shalom.